सितारे जिसकी गर्दे राह हूँ वो कारवां तू है।
बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर इन द बेस्ट स्टेट ऑफ इमान एंड हेल्थ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू ऑक्सफोर्ड मॉडर्न इंग्लिश यूनिट 1। दिस यूनिट इज़ अबाउट अ गर्ल नेम डोरोथी एंड वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द टाइम शी मीट्स अ स्केयरक्रो। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर रीडिंग नाउ। डोरोथी वॉक्ड अलोंग द रोड। It was made of yellow bricks. When she had gone some miles, she needed to rest. She climbed to the top of the fence beside the road and sat down. Her dog Toto was also tired. He lay down on the ground by the fence. There was a large cornfield on the other side of the fence, and in the field there was a scarecrow. So on this page we can see that there is a field of corn and there's this fence over here. Okay, fence are usually made of wood or bricks and they're used on the boundary of some place such as a field or any other building to protect what is inside or just to simply mark the boundary. Okay, so here we are reading about the time that Dorothy was walking and then she was tired, of course, because when you walk a lot you get tired, and then she rests on a fence. Okay, and that fence is around a cornfield, and in the cornfield is a scarecrow. A scarecrow is usually something that is made up of sacks and other such pieces of clothes, and it is stuffed with like some old clothes or straw or anything like that, and it is made to look like a real human being, a real man, and it is put inside fields so that the birds which eat the crops such as corn over here, they can be scared away. Okay, that is the purpose of a scarecrow. Dorothy gazed at the scarecrow. Its head was a small sack stuffed with straw. Its face was painted on the sack. It had an old pointed blue hat on its head. On its body it wore a blue suit. It wore a blue suit of faded clothes which had also been stuffed with straw. On the feet were some old boots. The scarecrow was tied to a tall pole. It was there to scare birds and stop them from eating the ripe corn. So here we get a whole description of the scarecrow, that it was it had a blue pointed hat on its head and it wore a blue suit. The suit was faded, which means that its color had lightened, okay, because of use, because it was old. And ripe means the corn which is almost ready to eat. Moving on. While Dorothy was looking at the painted face of the scarecrow, she was surprised to see one of the eyes slowly wink at her. She thought she must have imagined it. Then the scarecrow nodded its head to her in a friendly way. Dorothy climbed down from the fence and walked up to it. Toto ran around the pole and barked. So as she was sitting on the fence, the scarecrow, it winked at her, and she thought she might have imagined it was in her head, because scarecrows, they are not living things, they cannot move. Okay, so now let's see what happens actually. If is the scarecrow actually alive or is it not a living thing? So the scarecrow said, "Good day," said the scarecrow. "You didn't just speak, did you?" asked the girl in wonder. "Certainly," answered the scarecrow. "How do you do?" "I'm pretty well, thank you," replied Dorothy politely. "How do you do?" "I am bored," said the scarecrow. "It is very dull being stuck up here night and day to scare away crows." So now this is the conversation that is taking place between the scarecrow and Dorothy. The scarecrow politely greets Dorothy, which means he's a polite, respectful, kind scarecrow. And of course Dorothy is very surprised, because scarecrows don't usually speak and move. So let's see what further they talk about. So the scarecrow says that, "I'm very bored," said the scarecrow. "It is very dull being stuck up here night and day to scare away crows." "Can't you get down?" asked Dorothy. No, this pole is stuck up in my back. Please help me get down. So Dorothy asks that if you're really bored, then why don't you get down? To which the scarecrow replies that I cannot because the pole is stuck up in my back. Dorothy reached up both arms and lifted the scarecrow off the pole. He was quite light because he was only stuffed with straw. She set him down on the ground. So Dorothy is a helpful girl, so she lifted him up, the scarecrow up, and set him on the ground. And the scarecrow was very light. Why? Because it was filled with straw, and straw is something which is very light. Thank you very much, said the scarecrow. I feel much better. Dorothy was so surprised to hear a straw man speak. The scarecrow stretched and yawned. Who are you? Asked the scarecrow. And where are you going? My name is Dorothy, said the girl, and I am going to the Emerald City. Now, Dorothy and the scarecrow are discussing where Dorothy was going. I am going to ask the Great Oz to send me back to home, Kansas. I am going to ask the Great Oz to send me back home to Kansas. So Dorothy's home is in Kansas, and she wants to go to Emerald City to talk to Great Oz to send her back to her home in Kansas. Where is the Emerald City? Said the scarecrow. And who is Oz? Why, don't you know? She replied in surprise. So Dorothy was surprised that Scarecrow didn't know about the great wizard Oz. No, indeed, I don't know anything. You see, I'm stuffed with straw, so I have no brains at all, he answered sadly. So the scarecrow said that he doesn't know anything because he does not have any brains, because his head is also stuffed with straw. Oh, said Dorothy, I'm sorry for you. Do you think, he asked, if I go to the Emerald City with you, that Oz would give me some brains? I don't know, she replied. Come to the Emerald City with me and Toto. You can ask the Great Oz for a brain. So Dorothy didn't know whether Oz would help the scarecrow or not, but she said that why don't you just come along? What if he doesn't give me one? You should try anyway, said Dorothy. You have nothing to lose. So when the scarecrow said that what if he doesn't listen to my request, and Dorothy said you should still come, you know, because there's nothing that you're going to lose in this journey. Either you're going to get a brain or either you're going to remain as you were. That is true, said the scarecrow. You see, I don't mind my legs and arms and body being stuffed because I cannot get hurt. If anyone treads on my shoes or sticks a pin into me, it doesn't matter because I can't feel it. So the scarecrow is telling about the benefits of being stuffed with straw, that he cannot feel any pain. Dorothy listened carefully and nodded. She was amazed to see the scarecrow walking and talking. But I do not want people to call me a fool, and if my head stays stuffed with straw instead of brains as yours is, how am I ever to know anything? So the scarecrow was happy with its body being stuffed with straw, but he wanted to have a brain because he did not want people to call him a fool. I understand how you feel, said the little girl, who was truly sorry for him. If you will come with me, I'll ask Oz to do all he can for you. Thank you, he answered gratefully. Dorothy, Toto, and the scarecrow walked to the fence. They climbed over it and started walking along the yellow brick road towards the Emerald City. Toto sniffed around the straw man. He growled as if he suspected there might be a nest of rats in the straw. He was behaving in an unfriendly way because he did not know the scarecrow. So Toto was behaving unfriendly. He was growling at him because he did not know the scarecrow. Don't mind Toto, said Dorothy to her new friend. He never bites. Oh, I'm not afraid, replied the scarecrow. He can't hurt the straw. Toto, be nice, said Dorothy to her dog and bent down to pat him. Then she picked up her basket and they began walking again. So Dorothy told the scarecrow to not be afraid, but the scarecrow told Dorothy that he's not afraid of anything because he doesn't get hurt, nah? Do let me carry that basket for you. I shall not mind it, for I can't get tired, said the scarecrow. I'll tell you a secret, he continued as he walked along. There is only one thing in the world I'm afraid of. So let's find out what is the thing that the scarecrow is afraid of. What is that? Asked Dorothy. Is it the farmer who made you? No, answered the scarecrow. It's a lighted match. So we'll find out when we move on to the question answers. I'll ask you guys, why do you think that the scarecrow is afraid of a lighted match? That was all for today. Thank you very much. Stay blessed and safe.